Hello everybody, today let us see how to add a device into Zabbix. First thing is that once we come into the landing page of Zabbix, in the left pane we have to click on the configuration and then click on hosts. Once we are in host, this is how the page would look like. I have applied a filter for the host group called as hypervisors. And now let me create a host in this. So click on the create host in the top left corner. And then we have to give a host name. I don't have an actual name, so I will add a fictitious name called test16. And ideally we'll have to a mandatory field to give the group name. Because I was already in the hypervisor group, it has taken it by default. But otherwise, we will have to give a group name, which is mandatory. Now, coming to the interface part, I'm going to give an IP address, which is again a fictitious one. And here, the important thing is that, how are we going to monitor this? Is it an agent-based or an agentless? So in agentless, is it an ICMP type or SNMP type? What type exactly it is? So I haven't actually installed any agent on this because this is not a real server. So I'm going to add this as an ICMP type. So we will not have to do any other thing other than putting the host name, putting the group, and then putting the interface name in the first pane, which is in the host. Now coming to the templates tab, I have to assign a ping template and then click on add. That's it. I can see host test 16 added here. This is of the type ICMP. The same way, what we can do is when we click on create host and then we give a server called as test 17, which is in my case a fictitious one. I'm going to give the IP address and assume that this is actual a host in reality. In that case, we get the chance to install an agent on this, and I'm assuming that we will go with the default port 10050. Once this is done, then it starts monitoring this. Then let's go to the templates tab, and then I'm assuming that this is a Windows server. I deploy the default template called template OS Windows by Zabbix agent, and I click on add. It's as simple as that. Likewise, just to give an example, I have added a device which is present in real, and I've deployed a few templates. And here, once a real device is installed with Zabbix agent and starts communicating with Zabbix server, this thing becomes green. ZBX becomes green. But if we don't have that, then it turns to be red, or if the agent is not available. Okay. The other way to add a device is by SNMP. So let us click on create host, and then I give test 17, and then I give the same as hypervisors, and then I give it a fictitious, but it should not be the agent. Rather, I click on add, click on SNMP. Here, I give the IP address as something like this, because this is not a real device, and I assume it to be a SNMP v2 version, which I get validated from the network person. We can go with V1 or V2 or V3. V1 is least secure, which is really outdated and not used. V2 is though not completely outdated, but comparatively better to manage. SNMP V3 is one of the latest, which is having high security. Going with SNMP V2, we have to mandatorily give a community string. So either we can give it here, or we can write into the macros tab here. So let me give something. By default, SNMP community string is public. Now let us assume I have the community string set as test Zabbix. So with this, we will monitor the network device. Basically, SNMP monitoring is used for network devices or for the servers where we do not have the option to install the agent, either because of security or for some other reason. Now, the other thing that we have to do is remove the agent part, so only the SNMP part remains. Next, going to the templates tab, we have to type SNMP and start deploying a template that is more suitable for this. Let us assume that it's a Windows type server where I'm not able to install agent for some security reasons. So I select Windows SNMP. Assume that this is a network device, it's a Cisco router. Then I type SNMP and I see that I have something like template module generic SNMP. So I select this and I click on add. It's as simple as that. Oops, host 18 already exists. Let me just modify that to host 18. Click on add. That's it. It gets added like this. So as I said earlier, a device when we try to add as an agent based and if it is not available, it'll give an error like this, red. Either the Zabbix agent is not able to communicate to the server or it is down. In that case, we will get an indication in red that the agent is not able to communicate to the Zabbix server. More topics in the next one. Watch out.